The Arctic is a chilly area located at the northernmost part of Earth. It's made up of the Arctic Ocean, its adjacent seas, parts of Alaska, Greenland, Finland, Iceland, northern Canada, Russia, Sweden, and Norway. Over time, many strange anomalies have been discovered in this icy region, and we're going to explore some of them today. Strangest anomalies in the Arctic. 18. Lost and found. The Thames was a British steamship that sank in 1877. The discovery itself is not an anomaly, but finding a lost ship is always a little sad and eerie. The steamship was discovered near Goroshika, a village south of the Arctic Circle. Explorers were obsessed with this route during the 1800s, but took a further 100 years to be successfully navigated. The ship became frozen in the Kurika River after the crew spent the winter in the Yenisei. Parts of the ship were sold, her boilers bringing in the most money, and she was left to the elements thereafter. 17. Lost and lost. Unlike our ship that was discovered a couple of years ago, there is still no joy in finding the remains of the Soviet pilot Sigismund Levinevsky and his crew and their aircraft. They had attempted to be the first to fly over the North Pole from Moscow to Fairbanks, Alaska, on a cargo passenger ship, and it was believed they would need 12 months to prepare for the journey in 1937. However, in a bid to impress Stalin, the preparation took 3 months. All involved knew it would never work, and they were right. The crew and plane went down, never to be seen again. People have combed the area ever since and had no luck. Some believe that Levinevsky landed on an ice floe, was rescued by Germans and served for them, even assisting with the bombing of Moscow. 16. Hole-in-one. Siberia has seen some bizarre craters popping up all over the show. The largest is the Batagaika crater, which made its appearance in the 60s, and every year it widens by roughly 15 meters or 50 feet. Flame and billowing smoke was spotted in Sevak by reindeer herders in 2017, and an additional 10 craters appeared in that area. It seems that the buildup of methane gas caused the explosion, causing the permafrost to melt, which releases gas hydrates preserved in the ground, causing many sinkholes to form. Some prefer more plausible explanations, you know, like UFOs and gateways to the underworld. 15. Let there be monsters. Lake Ilima is the largest body of water in Alaska, and much like the Loch Ness Monster, this lake has its fair share of monster reports. The monster of Lake Ilima, or Illy for short, is supposedly a seriously large fish that allegedly lives in those waters. The Aleut people never used to fish in these waters for fear of this terrible monster. And pilots who have flown over these waters since the 1940s have all reported seeing something. Many believe it is a very large Pacific sleeper shark, which can grow up to 6 meters or 20 feet long. Again, the monster theory sounds a lot more plausible, wouldn't you agree? 14. Rain and snow. There has been a bizarre meteorological phenomenon that has taken place in the Arctic over the last few years, in which the northern snows turn into rain. Instead of the snow hitting the ground and melting into it, the rain causes an impenetrable shell on the surface of the ground, preventing the animals from grazing. In 2003, over 20,000 musk ox died of starvation. Some were so hungry, they searched for food on floating ice and were seen drifting out to sea. This could have disastrous effects, and scientists are tracking the strange phenomenon to see what can be done to prevent a huge disaster. 13. Make some noise. People living near Igloolik, Nunavut, in the Canadian Arctic, reported hearing strange pinging noises coming from the seafloor in 2016. The noises were so loud that they frightened the wildlife away. A team came out to investigate the problem, but all they found were pods of whales and 6 walruses. Having found no obvious threat, the team left. So, what plausible explanation could there be for the strange pinging noises? Aliens? The lost city of Atlantis? Or unknown giant underwater creatures? We'll let you decide. 12. Flight of the Eagle. A story worth retelling is that of Salomon August Andri, a young Swedish engineer who had a passion for balloon technology. He was studying in the US in the 1870s, and at this stage, no one had managed to reach the North Pole, and Andri believed it could be done using a hydrogen balloon. These balloons, theoretically, could stay in flight for 30 days, but only 15 days had been managed. He had a super financial contribution from the Swedish king and had a beautiful balloon made from varnished silk, roughly 30 meters or 100 feet high, and weighed 1.5 tons. In July 1897, Andri, along with civil engineer Knut Frankel and physics professor Niels Strindberg, took off from Svalbard in Norway and were never seen again. 30 years later, geologists and seal hunters came across a bleached skull and the ruins of a camp, and the cherry on top? The diary belonging to Andri. The diary revealed that the balloon had descended and was bumping against ice. The team came to land and tried to make their way to Franz Josef Land, but were unsuccessful. It's believed that Strindberg was the first to go, possibly a polar bear attack, and that Andri and Frankel may have contracted trichinosis after eating an undercooked polar bear. What really took place out there will remain a mystery forever. 11. Mystery solved. Originally bombing vessels, the HMS Terror and HMS Erebus were modified to be used for polar exploration. Captain Sir John Franklin guided the vessels through the previously unexplored Northwest Passage, but both ships became icebound. 129 men lost their lives. Separate expeditions to King William Island and Beechey Island in 1981 and 1982 led to the discovery of several men from the HMS Terror, buried in a mummified state. Cause of death was put down to tuberculosis, lead poisoning, and exposure to the elements. There was also evidence of cannibalism, with experts stating the men must have suffered from severe mental problems. The HMS Erebus remains were found in 2014, and 2 years later, the HMS Terror was also found in excellent condition. What really happened to the men will always be speculated. 10. Sound machine. Seeing the Aurora Borealis is high on the bucket list of many, and there's been an Arctic myth that the Borealis makes sounds. The Labrador Inuit believe that the spirits who died a violent death or gave themselves up voluntarily lived near a hole in the heavens and created this beauty to guide the recently deceased, accompanied with clapping sounds to communicate with the living. Scientists have dismissed these old stories as just myths and legends, until Aalto University's Unto Lane came forward with the theory that the sounds are real and probably created by the energetic particles from the sun that create the northern lights. Another theory is that the clapping sound is the result of tiny sparks discharging into the atmosphere. The sounds could reach the ground as radio waves and be played back audibly by the foliage. 9. Best left forgotten. A virus that lay dormant for 30,000 years was discovered by researchers in 2014, called the Pithovirus, now known as the giant virus. It's larger than normal specimens, including the Pandoravirus. It was found in the Siberian permafrost by Chantal Abergel and Jean-Michel Claverie, and is said to contain 500 genes. To explain this a little more clearly, the HIV virus has roughly 12 genes. What's freakier is that after lying dormant for 30,000 years, it's still active and can infect host cells. Fortunately, scientists don't believe it's a threat to us, but the thought of an ancient virus attacking humans once the ice melts is a little unsettling, isn't it? 8. Race to the finish. If you're an avid adventurer, then this is definitely something to add to your bucket list: a marathon across the North Pole. This race has been taking place yearly since 2002, and athletes compete in temperatures that reach minus 22 degrees. 2011 saw 255 people participate in this insane marathon, donning their goggles, thick clothing, and many pairs of socks to get to the finish line. It's a race that needs extreme stamina, not just physically, but mentally too. 7. Don't put your toes in the water. A long-nosed chimera fish might just take a nibble. This fish is extremely rare, and only two have ever been caught. They were caught in the waters of the Davis Strait in northern Canada. They are deep-sea dwellers, living between depths of 660 to 6,500 feet. It has earned the nickname Pinocchio and looks a lot like the goblin shark. The first dorsal fin on this rare fish is also a venomous spine, helping to protect it from predators. 6. Sunny days. It doesn't happen often, so you would have to plan a trip to the North Pole very carefully to witness this anomaly in the Arctic. The sunrise and sunset. This only happens once a year, and along with this rare phenomenon, means there is no time zone in the North Pole. Perfect for Santa and his relentless schedule to get all the presents ready. Most people heading to the North Pole will just stick to their time zone from home, but those studying that side will sync their watches with the closest time zone to their location. 5. North, South, East, West. Did you know that the North Pole has four different North Poles? The first is a terrestrial North Pole, a fixed point located directly opposite the South Pole. Then there's the North Dip Pole, an and to steal the explanation from discoverymagazine.com, where the geomagnetic field is perpendicular to the Earth's surface, there's the geomagnetic North Pole, and thanks to discoverymagazine.com, they explain that this North Pole is calculated using mathematical models based on an imaginary line running through the geomagnetic center of the Earth. The fourth and final one is the North Pole, Alaska, which is actually a little town quite far away from the other three North Poles and just happens to share a name. 4. Birds of a feather. They are birds that thrive in the freezing conditions of the North Pole and migrate each year to the South Pole. They manage to cut the 20,000 miles, or 32,000 kilometers, to just over 12,000 miles, or 19,000 kilometers, by diverting their route via a loop. Many birds, animals, and humans live in the Arctic Circle, despite the freezing conditions. A tribe of Inuits live within the circle, and bears and reindeer thrive there. 3. It's getting cold in here. So, how cold is the North Pole? The average temperature is in the region of minus 50 degrees centigrade, but the lowest ever recorded temperature was minus 89.6 degrees centigrade in 1983. On a side note, the South Pole is much colder than the North Pole because it sits on a blanket of thick ice. 2. What lies beneath? Beneath the depth of these northern lands lie some of the richest natural resources in the world. And because of its harsh location, the raw material lies virtually untouched. There is an abundance of hydrocarbon and mineral resources. There are also huge concentrations of mineral deposits, copper, nickel ore, platinum, and other earth metals like phosphorus, chromium, diamonds, silver, gold, and more. If you were given the opportunity, would you make a trip to the Arctic? And if so, what would you most like to see? Let us know in the comments below. 1. Ancient life. One amazing thing that the Arctic Circle is bringing forward is specimens of ancient life. Microfossils dating back 4 billion years have been discovered in the Arctic Circle, tucked away on Canadian rocks, proving that Earth could host life all of those billions of years ago. Thanks for watching. Like this video over here and subscribe for more right over here.